Welcome to another Flipped Classroom tutorial where I share quick tech tips on educational technology. Now, we all create some screencasts from time to time to share with our students, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how you can create an attractive thumbnail or a nice introduction screen to your tutorial. Now I will show you two different ways of doing this, the first being Google Draw and the second by using a different app. So let's go ahead and start off with Google Drawings. Click on New and create a new Google Drawing. The important thing to remember is that there is a recommended size for thumbnails, and that recommended size is 1280 to 720. So let's go ahead and change our page setup. We can click on Page Setup and we are going to select Custom. This will enable us to change the size of our file. So I want 1280 by 720. Click on OK. And this is now my complete thumbnail. My suggestion would be to create your own thumbnails using your own photos or your own images. If you do not have your own images, then there are various websites you can visit. One of those websites is Stocksnap. So I'm going to go ahead and open stocksnap.io. This is a wonderful website with lots of free stock photos. Now let's say that my screencast is all about children playing. So let's say children playing. And I do a quick search for stock photography of children playing. Now the website stocksnap.io is going to present me with lots of images I can freely use. Now I'm going to go with a black and white design for this one. So I'm going to just select the first image and I'm going to download the high resolution photo. Once I've done that, I can import that photo into my Google Drawing. As you can see, it's downloading right here. I'm going to go to my other tab. And the wonderful thing about Google Drawings is when you're using Google Chrome is that I can simply click, drag, and drop. This saves me a lot of time, and I do not have to worry about getting things right. Next, we're going to have to crop this image. Now, in order to make sure that we see the lines, I am going to go to Image Options and I'm just going to set the transparency to, let's say, 30-40% so I can actually see where my canvas ends. This way I can easily crop the image. All done. Simply tap Enter. We can now set the transparency back to, let's say, 10% or less, and we close our Image Options. Next, I want to add the title of my lesson. So let's go ahead and create a text box. Let's have a nice bold text box at the top. And then we are going to say playing outdoors. Let's say that our video is all about playing outdoors. Playing outdoors. I can now make sure that this is nicely aligned in the center. I will change my font. I quite like this one. Change our font size, playing outdoors, go for a white text color, bold, and add a, let's add a black fill. So let's go to fill and a black fill. There we go. This stands out already, playing outdoors. And maybe down below I want to have a little note on who's made this video. There we go. Very basic thumbnail. Once you've done this, you can select everything, go to File, Download as PNG. Google Drawings is now going to create this file, turn it into a PNG file, which you can then in turn import into your video editor or upload to YouTube when you're sharing this video. Now, when you're creating these thumbnails, make sure they reflect your own personal style. Not every design goes with every type of video. This was created fairly quickly just for the sake of this demo. I would probably not use this sort of design for my videos. Now, the second way that we can create thumbnails like this is by using an external app. So let's go ahead and go to Apps. And I am going to install a new app. So let's go to the web store and let's find Canva. Now, some of you have probably already heard of Canva, as it is a great tool to create all sorts of really good looking graphic designs. Now, we're going to add this app. As you can see, it only takes a small minute. We're going to open the app and we're going to sign in with Google. Seeing as we're already signed into our Google, we can simply allow Canva to use our Google account. Once you've done all that, it is as simple as simply opening Canva and starting a new design. So I'm going to go to create a design. You can also use these examples, or you can use custom dimensions, and this is the one we are going to select. So let's go to custom dimensions and let's go with the same dimensions as before, 1280 by 720. Design. I'm now presented with my design. What you will do next is you are going to give this a title, and then you can start designing. Now, as you can see, we can choose any of these already pre-made setups. Now, I'm simply going to go with this one because I want a background image. Now, this image can be any image you already have. So you simply go to upload, and then you can drag and drop your image. Let's upload my file. Downloads 8T, here it is, and open. This file will now be uploaded to Canva and imported into my design. And here it is. Let's go ahead and drag this onto our work. Let's get rid of this other image. Resize it so that it fits my canvas. And as you can see, because we've already set the dimensions, we do not have to crop this. It will simply adjust my image. Now let's go to text, let's add a heading. Let's call this outdoor playing. And we're also going to add a little subheading, which will say the same thing as our other thumbnail, made by Flipped Classroom Tutorials. Here we go, a very simple and fast way of creating thumbnails or intro images for your videos. Once you've done this, you simply click on download, PNG, and the same as with Google Drawings, you will be presented with a PNG file of your thumbnail, which you can then upload to YouTube or insert into your video editor. Now let's open this file, and here is my thumbnail. So, two ways of creating beautiful thumbnails. Number one, Google Drawings. Number two, Canva. Two perfectly okay apps to create your video thumbnails. I hope this was helpful. If you found this video helpful, please leave a comment below. Give me a thumbs up, subscribe for more videos, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you for watching.